Here we are going to see about strain. This is a continuation video after the previous one, stress. So I am Ilavenil and this video is under Creative Commons license CC by SA. Why study strain? We have seen stress in previous video. We see stress as the cause of strain. We have seen that stress produces deformation. We have also seen that deformation is change in dimension. Change can be shape, size, or both. Deformation. Stress values at every localized area creates local deformations. Total deformation is the net effect of the individual deformations. Gauging the deformation. Assume we have 1 mm deformation. How do we see this? High or low or moderate? Let us see a set of cases. A 0.1 mm blade deforms 1 mm. Say increase. How do we see this? There is another case. A 1 mm wire deforms 1 mm with an increase. And we also have a very funny case. A 1 mm wire deforms 1 mm in decrease where it is not going to exist at all. So the next case, a 20 mm rod deforms 1 mm. And in yet another case, a 4 m beam deforms 1 mm. Need for strain. We can also assume many more cases practically as well as hypothetically. All they show is 1 mm deformation is not the same everywhere. It is crucial that a deformation value is considered high or low based on original dimension or functional requirements. Comparison with the original dimension gives out a new term called strain, driven by practical need. Strain. Strain is the ratio of change in dimension to the original dimension. How this becomes significant? We know that it is stress that creates deformations. But again, stress alone doesn't decide upon the deformation values. Stress, however, decides how much is the strain. Young's modulus. Every material, by its own virtue, has a capacity to resist deformation. That property, which is independent of dimensions and purely material based, is its modulus of elasticity or Young's modulus. According to Hooke's law, within elastic limit, stress is proportional to strain. Here, the ratio of stress to strain is its Young's modulus, which is a constant for a particular material. Importance of strain. Now, based on quantity of stress, the quantity of strain is obtained. As discussed earlier, the localized stresses create localized strains, and the total strain is obtained as a net effect. So, the total deformation is obtained from total strain. Strain values are direct result of stresses, and strain values are practically valuable.